college here, we're doing something that we haven't done in approximately 50 years, and that is dedicate a brand new building here on our campus. How exciting is that? So as someone personally that has enjoyed the arts in many different ways here at Lincoln Trail College, as somebody that has taken lessons, performed here on stage, and also been out in the audience and enjoyed our plays and our different concerts and ensembles, it is incredibly exciting for us to expand the arts here at Lincoln Trail College with this brand new building, and I'm very, very excited. So we have a really great program planned for you tonight, several speakers, and we're going to start things off with the Star Spangled Banner. So I would like to bring Becca Jess, who will be graduating from Lincoln Trail College next week, on stage to perform the national anthem. So,
$1.4 million into this building and the building that we're celebrating in our groundbreaking. And
every single penny of that, with the exception of the concrete, was privately fundraised from this local community. And I think that deserves a round of applause. I was thinking about the building, and the building really is an exciting addition to Lincoln Trail. With this building, we now have a very nice choral room. We have got a mid-sized lecture hall, which, believe it or not, is the very first mid-sized lecture hall that Lincoln Trail College has ever had. And, of course, we've got all the wonderful rooms that are out there for community education, for students to come in from the local communities to take vocal and instrument lessons. Dr. Patil is here, so it's a great addition to this campus. But I want to say this, more exciting than what the building actually is, and as Chris said, the first brick-and-mortar construction on this campus in more than 50 years, it's really about what that building was meant to represent to this community. To me, this building is a reminder to our Board of Trustees, to the Lincoln Trail College Foundation, and also to all of the members of this campus community, that if you think small, and you plan small, and you dream small, you will get small results. And for this campus to go 50 years and not have any addition and to not grow is inexcusable. And I think one of the things that I'm so excited about with the leadership from our board, the leadership from this campus, is our dreams are getting bigger, our plans are getting bigger, and our desire to impact this community is getting stronger. And so to me, more than what this building is, it's the representation of what we have. And I know that a little bit later, the president of the college is going to tell you about some of the projects that we still have planned for the future. We've of course had the addition of our Statesmen Park. We'll soon have the addition of the Technology Center, which is 20 years in the making. But long story short, it's an exciting time to be at Lincoln Trail. I'll close with this, and it's really just my desire for all four of the colleges at Illinois Eastern Community Colleges. We want our campuses to be the hub. We want to be the center of activity for our local communities. Whether you're young, whether you're old, whether you're seeking a degree or not, we want our campuses to be places where there's something here for you to engage. Because this campus is more than issuing degrees and certificates, it's about changing lives, and that's an exciting thing to be a part of. So thank you very much for the opportunity to speak. I'm proud to be here tonight. Now I'd like to welcome the president of Lincoln Trail College, Dr. Zahi Atala, to stage.
Thank you so much. For those who don't know me, I'm Zahi. It's really hard to come after Brian Gower and the energy that he brings. I came on board July the 1st of last year, so this was a done deal. And I'm speaking, hopefully, about the future. The future that's brighter because of all of you. The future that has been bright since the first day, but it's even brighter every single day because of the efforts and the vision and the funding that all of you provide, whether through your taxes or through your contributions, personal and or business contributions. We heard from Dr. Gower about the Statesmen Park, we've heard about the Rec Center, the tech building that Dr. Pachisi can tell us when did you first hear about it, right? It's been a dream, and hopefully it will become a reality. The money's allocated, the boat has left the dock, we're set. Now, when will it arrive to the destination? Hopefully soon. But it's beyond the buildings. It's the opportunities for our community. The Lackey Music Hall offers opportunities for all of us, whether we're students or members of our community, because it will allow us to offer a specialized concert. But for that matter, they'll start it. It'll allow us to diversify our musical offerings, which is critical. We don't want a drain of the talent outside of Crawford County. Therefore, we should anchor them here. And this is in line with the work that I'm very proud to be involved with in terms of enhancing the workforce of Crawford County by investing in daycare, by housing to be attractive, even more attractive than we have been. As you heard, we want to be a hub, but in many ways we are a hub. I invite you all, if you haven't bought your tickets, to come on the 5th for the Beatles 1964 tribute. Where are they going to play? They're not playing out in the square of the town. They're playing here. We had one not too long ago, one concert. So we want to be a comprehensive institution in terms of the art offerings, because we need to keep on growing. We need to keep on rooting the youth of this county in this county. And we want to be able to bring talents from the outside. Drove from Madison, Wisconsin, that's outside. We want to keep bringing in more talent to this area and keeping them here. So at the end of the day, we want to become an art education destination, not just an afterthought. And that started with what you've all done as a gift to us with the Lackey Music Hall. With that, I'm grateful. We're going to hear from others, probably will say things that are much more valuable. But for me, the most valuable thing is that you're here. You've been here for us for years, and we're grateful for all of you.
Thank you, Greg. I remember very well how this whole thing started. Dr. Dower, Ryan, and I, we were talking, and he said, how would we get this thing off the ground? And I said, we need to make a run out to the lake out there by Madisonville somewhere.
It's not
broadcasting. And see,
Jim Ryan,
he's our music expert on the foundation. And we did, and we visited, and the Renaissance Committee was born. And now here we are. And I want to thank everyone in the community for your support, the Lincoln College Foundation. And we have a fundraiser, which I always love. Everybody gets tired of me doing that. But we do have a fundraiser. But a special thanks to the Foundation Board, and a very special thanks to Jim Rogers. Thank you, Jim.
Record a video with her before, so please welcome her video to stage.
I still remember the day that Ryan Gower came over to the theater department and found me backstage and asked for kind of a tour and some issues. And out of that conversation, I gained excitement that maybe we might be able to look at some of these issues, and it turned into even a bigger plan than I thought. Out of that meeting, that day, that discussion, came the Theater Renaissance program. So this building started as a theater, an idea how to help not build sets on the stage. So a committee was formed, Rod Harmon, Jim Rogers, Rebecca Carmack, Larry Quick, and we met and we brainstormed, and Ryan Gower, of course, and came up with plans and what we would envision. Well, this process took quite a while. We even had an architect rendering for a building totally in a different location, and we were pretty far down the road, but it didn't feel right. It didn't feel like this was the best use of funds and time, and the folks that would be in that building would be only building. And we felt like the public needed to be in the building. So actually Rebecca and I and Ryan came up with the idea, wait a minute, why are we not building a music building that the future can enjoy, the choirs, the practice rooms, and it separates the sound from the choral room, because a choral room is an awful place to practice when you're trying to practice on stage or when you're having performances on stage. So it suited a lot of needs. I'm ever so proud of the work that went into this. I feel like I know that we had some serious donors so pleased with the vision that they see for the future, because this new building will enable students to come in and have a lovely place to practice, a place to have classes. It allows the college an extra classroom if they need it for a large group. I'm just so excited about LTC and their investment in the future of the theater and the music department.
Yeah, I've done it before.
Now I'd like to welcome another longtime member of the Performing Arts and Lincoln Trail College to stage, Iman Newland.
Where I received my bachelor's of music and organ staying overnight in the hospital, and they would appreciate your prayers. Phil's never been in the hospital a day in his life, and so they would really appreciate your prayers. He told me while Phil would call to give me an update on Phil's condition. He said, "I was all ready to tell lots of stories about starting to teach people with campus." He's got stories to tell, let me tell you. He said, especially the one when we were teaching music in the men's locker room, and the athletes would come in after practice and change and leave their stinky clothes in the locker room, and they would pick up and go right on to music rehearsal. And he has lots of stories to tell. So keep her in your prayers, but keep in mind that because of him, this whole thing started.
Now I'd like to welcome the current director of the Arts at Lincoln Trail College to stage, Dr. Michael Platella.
Thank you. So I started working at Lincoln Trail as music instructor and director of the fine arts in August. So in contrast to a lot of people that you've heard from tonight, I'm really pretty new. And my family, we lived up here in December of 2018, so it's approaching about 4 years that we've been living here. And before we came, we didn't know anything about Robinson. We didn't know anything about Lincoln Trail College. And years, I've been a musician for many years. I've traveled all over the world. I studied at three different schools. I've taught at a lot of different schools. I've performed concerts and taught at so many different types of arts organizations internationally. And I have to say that Lincoln Trail probably is one of the nicest places for receiving support. There's support from the administration, support from the community, and kind of piggybacking on Yvonne's story. I think that's the first time I've heard the story about teaching music classes in the men's locker room. So what I was thinking as she was saying that is that there's a lot of great people here who for many years have made do. They get by. And we were getting by, and I'm speaking for other people like Rebecca and Yvonne and Barb Scheimer. These wonderful faculty members and staff members here at Lincoln Trail, they got by. They did what they had to do without Lackey Music Hall. They were able to tiptoe around each other and, hey, we've got to build sets on stage, we've got to do this, we've got to do that. And really, in a lot of ways, we do that every day here. We help each other out, we work together. But so these people making do and getting by. So we have to ask the question.
I don't know why.
And I think somebody asked the question when they started planning for Lackey Music Hall. Somebody must have asked the question, are we going to get by or are we going to be excellent? And I think the answer to that question is right out here. When you drive into campus and you see that beautiful orange pop of color when you're driving in, that answers that question because I think all of us here and all of you have made. And for me, coming in after the fact, being hired in August after all the plans had been made, after all the fundraising, everything had been built, I come into this beautiful new building. All I can say is thank you. Thank you to everyone involved. And it's an honor for me to be here every day. I actually left music for a little while, for about 3 years. I wasn't teaching music. I really thought I was done doing music. Being a music teacher can be hard, and these people here, I'm looking at, they can say it's emotionally draining. I actually got a little bit burned out. I was so burned out on teaching music that my family, we moved here to Robinson, several hundred miles away, and I took a job at the prison. And so I can promise you that when I took my job at the prison, my stress levels and my blood pressure went way down from being a musician. But the people here at Lincoln Trail have welcomed me, these new facilities, the support that I received from the administration and from the community has gotten me excited about being a music teacher. And for that, I thank you all very much.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for the singing of the Lincoln Trail College alma mater from our combined choir of Statesmen Singers, concert choir, and faculty. A wonderful rendition of that. One of the highlights here as we finish up the night, we will have tours of Lackey Music Hall, and you will find the original handwritten lyrics to the alma mater on the wall in Lackey Music Hall. So I'm proud to say that we have another part of our history there. So. In closing tonight, again, a wonderful historic night here for Lincoln Trail College as we dedicate this brand new building. We do have hors d'oeuvres for you outside, help yourself. We'll also have tours of Lackey Music Hall available, and thank you all for coming tonight.